losing versus finding?
Losing was all about the struggles, starting off as a dyslexic 15-year-old, trying to campaign against the Vietnamese War, and then building Virgin from scratch, from nothing to what it became. And that was tremendously exciting, and we had the ballooning adventures and trying to survive that. And then finding my virginity is the last 20 years where we've also had some quite extreme struggles. I mean, obviously you've got the whole space program. We started it 12 years ago. It's had some wonderful moments. It's had some very sad moments. We think we're on the verge of finally getting VSS Unity, our new spaceship, into space.
Brilliant.
Maybe in the next 3 months now. And then
when are you hoping to go?
I'm hoping to be up within about 6 months from now.
Awesome.
Really?
Getting very close now.
And then, Sir Richard Branson.
I hope, and this is my dream, that a lot of kids that are watching this program will one day be able to become astronauts. Because we're not just building one spaceship, we're building a number of spaceships. And if it's as popular as I think it will be, we can take a lot of people to space over the years to come. And the more spaceships we can build, the more that we can get the price down.
Big announcement coming as well from Sir Richard.
Completely and utterly magnificent. Being in space, looking back at this beautiful fragile Earth of ours. And,
I mean, when you talk about this project, about business generally, it's quite emotional for you.
Yeah, it's a big announcement coming by Sir Richard Branson. And I told you guys about it. Now you're going to see it materialise before you.
Seems that obviously over the course of a long, successful career, some businesses haven't worked out, some have worked out exceptionally well, you've sold them for a lot of money. Do you have difficulty parting with them, regardless of the
circumstances? Of course. I mean, when, we had a new airline, Virgin Atlantic, 30 years ago, and British Airways threw everything at it to try to put it out of business, and they launched something called the Dirty Tricks campaign, so I had to sell a record company, which we just signed the Rolling Stones and Janet Jackson, in order to get the financial resources to combat British Airways, and despite having a $1 billion check in my pocket, I also had tears in my eyes, because if you're selling a company, you're selling people, but we didn't stop there, and we managed to sort of bounce back in
on
lots
again.
Of different
Next.
Areas. And I love creating things. I love it when somebody jumps on one of our products and we get fantastic feedback. And if we see we had a big announcement today, which was exciting. Our trains are capable of going 170 miles an hour on the West Coast. But
they're going to go much faster.
The tracks are not great. They're restricted to about 125 miles an hour. We've been working in the Las Vegas desert, creating something called Virgin Hyperloop.
Yes!
Virgin Hyperloop will
there it is.
A train that will levitate on magnets and will travel faster than an aeroplane.
750 miles an hour.
And we will hopefully be able to get permission from the government to build a tunnel between.
Well done, well done.
Forty-five minutes
between Glasgow and London.
Well, we'll actually be ready to start building in about 2 years' time. So it's soon, and obviously, look, we're going to sit down with the government and work out that great thing about a tunnel is you're not going to have to cut down beautiful forests and things to get there. And we could even do it along a current rail track, or we could do it along the waterways, the side of the waterways. But
once you go via Glasgow,
it's a yes to me.
Like me. You were watching last night, your